Hello and welcome. I really appreciate you all joining me, and I have been enjoying the response that we've been getting from people regarding the episodes and the sessions that we've been doing on overcoming blood magic. And if you haven't seen it, I want you to go back through and read. We talk about the components of blood magic. We talk about what it is, how people use it. And I want you to understand that what we're talking about is not in its totality. So like, it's really huge. What we do is we share bits of information so that you can go out and research and study and fast and let the Spirit of God in you begin to minister to you, understanding of how it may relate to your life or the lives of others, or those that you may need to intercede and pray for, those who you kind of mentor. So I also am uploading a video that has to do with preparing to overcome certain forces, certain demonic infiltration, certain hidden residue that may be obscure and yet working profusely in your life, and you're unable to see what the enemy is. So before you go into trying to engage an enemy that you can't see and that you don't fully understand, I want you to watch a video that we're going to be uploading soon that talks about, you know, preparing to engage when you're talking about blood magic and other forces like that. So we sort of give you the fundamentals and the basics. And then what we do is we give you an understanding of what you need to do to prepare to go into battle. You know, anytime there's a battle, there's an engagement, you prepare for everything, prepare for testing, you prepare for those things. And so sometimes you may think you are prepared, but the more that you understand about your opponent, about your enemy, and about your savior, and about your commander in chief, and about your constitution, and your citizenship, and your authority, and your power that you've been given in the Holy Ghost, then it gives you the strength that you need to be able to stand. So there is a video that we'll be uploading. It's entitled Pump Your Brakes, How to Overcome Blood Magic. And what happened is that the Spirit of God was talking to me, and he revealed to me, you know, people are trying to engage these forces and they don't have the information that they need to be prepared. So I should have done that one first. I didn't, but we're going to be uploading it. So tonight we're going to be talking about, I told you that we were going to talk more about Akashic Records. And so tonight we're going to talk about Akashic Records. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful to you for this opportunity to seek first your kingdom and your righteousness. We acknowledge you. We acknowledge that you are present in us, that you dwell in us richly by your Spirit. Your word tells us so. So we acknowledge your presence in us, the presence of God in us, we acknowledge. And now we ask that you would direct our path, that you would lead, guide, and direct. We thank you, Father, and we decree and declare, for my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. So you know what every viewer will need. You understand what needs to resonate right now. I don't know, but you know. And so this life that I live in the flesh, I live it by the faith of the Son of God. And I am trusting now by the faith of the Son of God that it's not by my might or power, but by your Spirit, that your word will prevail. So in Galatians 6:8, it says that whoever sows to the flesh, from the flesh will reap destruction. And whoever sows to the Spirit, from the Spirit will reap eternal life. Here's the thing. We are spiritual beings. We have an energetic vibrational resonance. And we are magnetic beings. And the way that God set us up is whatever man soweth, that's what he reaps. So whatever you sow, whatever you expend, whatever you release, is what you will magnetize unto yourself. Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. Well, likewise, those mindsets and energies that we release, it's what we magnetize unto us because we are magnetic beings. And so having understood that, we were talking about Akashic Records. And I want you to know that as we go into more in-depth understanding, not just blood magic, but other curses and incantations that have been going forth that people have been using for years, hundreds and thousands of years, we want to understand that there are Akashic records, and we want to understand that in relation to the book of life. So whatever man sows, that shall he also reap. Means that whatever we release by way of energy, whatever we release, whatever we vibrate, whatever we resonate in, that is what we're going to attract to us. But not just for us, but for generations to come. And so as we look into the phrase, the book of life, it appears in the Bible, specifically in the New Testament. In Revelation 3:5, it says that I will confess the name before the Father and before the angels. The one who conquers will be clothed thus in white garment, and I will never blot his name out of the book of life. In Revelations 13:8, all who dwell in the earth worship him, and everyone whose name has been written in the book from the foundation of the world, the book of life of the Lamb who has been slain. Revelation 20:15, and if anyone's name is not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Edgar Cayce, a clairvoyant who was actually from the state of Alabama, which is where I now reside. Edgar Cayce was a clairvoyant. He's a Christian. He talked about the book of life. He talked about Akashic records. And what he talked about was how water is eternal. Water was here when God created the heaven and earth and this universe. Water was here. It was the whole body was encompassed with water. It was full of water. So then he separated it. God separated. He separated the firmament. Water in the heaven, water in the earth, and condensation throughout the earth. And we are filled with water. So when he formed us in the dust of the earth and we were not animated, we didn't have any life, and he breathed into our nostrils the breath of life, there was condensation, there was humidity, there was water, there was electricity that gave us animation. We are filled with water because we're electrical magnetic beings, and that water is a conduit. And as we begin to speak to ourselves and minister to ourselves, our auditory system begins to use a cochlear micromechanic system to little auditory hairs throughout our body. And that water begins to travel on those little auditory hairs and carry the message that we speak to ourselves, our self-talk, throughout every organ in our being, and begins to transmit information. Well, that same water that has not been destroyed, that has been here since before time, is a record keeper. It's a record keeper. 1 John 5:8 tells us that three bears witness in the earth. We know three bear witness in the heaven. That's the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. They are one. Well, in the earth, three agree as one. 1 John chapter 5, verses 8-9 tells us that those three are the spirit, the water, and the blood. And these three align themselves and they agree as one. Even as it pertains to human testimony, they agree as one. And so what happens is we're talking about a witness here. And so even if we accept human testimony, the testimony of God is greater. For this is the testimony that God has given about his Son. It goes on to talk about the Son of God and how he came in the image of God, how we were created in the image of God. It talks about the work, the specific work of Christ Jesus here, and how we are able to walk in his righteousness. And then it talks about if you have a human testimony, a human witness that's contrary to the image that we've been created in the image of Christ Jesus, then the witness of God is greater. Well, he's given us the witness of blood, water, and spirit in this earth. Water is an eternal witness. Water was here before he formed the earth. It was obscurity. Everything was dark and void. And then the Spirit of God began to move upon the face of the what? The water. Water is a witness. Blood is a witness. The Spirit is a witness. And when you talk about the Spirit, you're talking about the ethereal. You're talking about the energetic forces that are being used even to transmit this broadcast in the internet, in the waves. All of that is the energetic force, Spirit. Ethereal. Those bear witness in this earth as one. Why is that important? Because the water is talking. It's been here since before we were here. it bears a record. It gives a witness. You know, people get baptized when they accept Christ as Savior. They also get baptized into satanic situations. And so what happens is water bears a record. It's a witness in the eternal. It's a witness in the book of life. It's a witness in the Akashic Records, and they are not the same, though they both bear an eternal record. One is for the soul and one is for the heavenlies. The book of life is for the heavenlies, for the eternal. And the Akashic Records is for the soul. It's a record of what's taking place in the vibrational resonance and energetic composite of the soul. So as we talk about the book of life, we know in Luke chapter 10 verse 20, it says, "Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this," talking about how the demons were subject to the use of God's name. And God said, yeah, of course. Jesus said, of course. "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." He said, but listen, don't rejoice in that. That's not the important part. You need to rejoice in the fact that your name is written and recorded in heaven. Philippians 4:3, "Indeed, true companion, I ask you also to help these women who have shared my struggle in the cause of the gospel, together with Clement also, and the rest of my fellow workers whose name are written in the book of life." So as we talk about the difference between the book of life and how it's written in the eternal, how it's written in the heavens, in the eternals, and how the Akashic Records speaks to the soul, the mind, will, and the emotion, and the records that bear witness of the mind, will, and emotion, the soul, and all of its thoughts, and all of its behavior, and all of its propensities, and all of its generational forces. That's what the Akashic Records records. And there is a difference. We may not be able to finish all of this now, but I promise you we'll come back and talk about it, because the significance is that we've been talking about blood magic. Well, there are certain forms of blood magic that will use Akashic Records to go back and either astral project or use the imagery from the Akashic Records to now bind or bond people or link them to a curse, an ancient curse. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Ancient forces. And they're using the Akashic Records, but you can use the records of the book of life to declare that your name is written in the book of life. Like he said, you know, yeah, you know, the demons are subject to you through my name. And that's a wonderful thing. You're using the authority that God has given you to exercise the power that's been given to you through the power of the Holy Ghost. That's great. But that's not the most important thing. The most important thing is that your name is inscribed in heaven in the book of life. And you can now speak that word that's in the book of life over any forms of forces and demonic infiltrations that are being used using Akashic Records. So your soul might have been programmed into a certain type of lifestyle, and you may have repented. And then years from now, here comes your grandchild. But they've got those propensities, of course, in the bloodline, you know, because we talked about blood being a genetic being and having a genetic history, and how those who practice divination can use that to begin to declare certain things. But you want to teach your children how to declare that their name is written in the book of life, how to declare their grandmother and their grandfather's name, or their mother or their father, their uncle, their cousin, whoever was interceding in their behalf, the preacher that's over their soul or shepherding them. Their name was written in the book of life. Jesus Christ, is the author and the finisher of their faith. They need to know how to declare these things over forces that would attempt to question and challenge who they are. So as we talk more about the Akashic Records, they're described as energetic collection of imprints that contain information about a person's soul. So we know, let's imagine that it's a cosmic library overflowing with all type of data from throughout the time when humans were here. See, it's recording the soul. So it's going to start at the time when humans were created, when God created male and female, when humans were created. It's going to record that. But when you look at the book of life, it's recording the eternal even prior to that, because water is involved as a witness for the eternal. And because water is involved, water was here before anyone was here, before God did his work, when everything was void and obscure and dark, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the water. And even though it was a dark and dismal situation, he opened his mouth and said, "Let there be." I want to pause for a moment and say to somebody, it may be looking dark and dismal, but you need to open your mouth and begin to speak. Now, the Word of God has the highest vibrational resonance that exists, so open your mouth and begin to speak it. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. For my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Begin to speak the Word of God. Begin to release it, to send it forth over dark and dismal, obscure situations. And as that word goes forth, the Spirit of God is moving upon the face of the water. You see, you're comprised of mostly water. So when you begin to speak, the Spirit of God is moving upon the face of the water in you, upon the face of the water in the atmosphere, upon the face of the water in the heavens and in the earth and beneath the earth. You just need to send the word forth, and the word does the work because it bears the highest vibrational resonance that exists. And so when we talk again about the Akashic Records, these are the records of the souls. These records include past, present, and future aspects of an individual's journey across lifetimes in its realm. So it actually contains different decisions that one may make and the outcomes that would exist from that. So I don't know if those of you who are watching have ever experienced the Spirit of God giving you revelation. I told you all that what made me start talking about overcoming black and blood magic was that at the beginning of the year, I had heard a prophecy that was given by my nephew, Christopher Battle. It was a very powerful prophecy. I had written it down and I was going over it in my heart, praying in the Holy Ghost as I went to sleep. And as I went to sleep, I was not feeling my best. I had been feeling symptoms of sickness and I was declaring the word. And the Spirit of God spoke to me in my sleep, gave me revelation and an understanding of the divination that had attacked me. And it was a certain form of blood magic that was working. He told me how to pray, what to pray, and where to direct my prayer. And as that happened, I saw instant relief from those symptoms. And those symptoms have not come back. And so I knew then that there was something going on. And as time went by, God began to reveal to me, you need to start to teach about this, because people are not aware that this has been taking place since mankind has been here. And so you want to talk more about this. And he began to give me revelation as to what direction I needed to go in. So we're talking about Akashic Records because of how it's used in this form of blood magic. Which is also a form of black magic, but it doesn't even matter because God is the true source and everything else is a fake. As I mentioned before, I heard a sermon from Dr. Kimberly Mann as she spoke about how to spot a fake. We know that anything contrary to the blood of Jesus is a fake. Amen. Walking about seeking whom he may devour. And this is why God has us talking about this, so that you would understand this information, how to apply it, how to pray, how to hear from the Spirit of God, so that you will know how to overcome and how to release others. So the records includes past, present, and future aspects of an individual's journey across all lifetimes and realms. And so in every impulse or feeling or thought, spoken word or action, there's an imprint that's left in these records, because we're vibrational beings Everything about us and everything that exists has a vibrational resonance. Things may appear to be stationary, but I promise you, depending on their molecular structure, they are not stationary. They are not solid. They are comprised by a particular molecular vibrational resonance. All of us. And when we release words, words go forth as things, as an energy, as a life force. They go forth as seeds that are being planted to become whatever it is that we send them forth as. Matter of fact, they go forth as what we've sent them forth as. And we begin to see the manifestation of that word. The manifestation of God's word is called glory. When we see God's word manifested in life, it's called glory. Accessing Akashic Records can provide insights into various aspects of life, including issues that people face in a lifetime and questions about past experiences. And see, that's where people that operate in divination begin to go in. But I want you to know something. Because these records actually report and program and record and bear witness to different things that have happened that have to do with each individual's soul, the mind, will, and emotion, there is a prayer that you can pray to the Heavenly Father, and He will give you revelation even from these records that have in-depth records and occurrences and instances about what have taken place in an individual's soul, in their mind, their will, and their emotions. Well, it's just about time for me to stop. Looks like we've got about 4 more minutes. So when we talk about the origins of Akashic Records, they're ancient and they span across different cultures and spiritual traditions. When we talk about Christianity, that's what I really want to focus on. I'm trying not to go into anything that has not to do with Christianity. But in Christianity, the concept of Akashic Records refers to the Book of Life mentioned in the Bible. And again, I talked about Edgar Cayce, and he was an American clairvoyant that he played a significant role in popularizing Akashic Records so that people will understand what he was referring to when he referred to God's Book of Remembrance. He believed that it contained information about every individual, whoever had lived in this earth. And remember, it's recording about the soul, the mind, will, and emotion. So while the Book of Life spans over forever, this is talking about the mind, will, and emotion, the soul of mankind. And so those records begin when the first soul, when man became a living soul. And as we compare it with the Bible, the Book of Life, the Akashic Records share similarities with the Book of Life. So they both are repositories of information related to the soul and their journey. But the Book of Life also refers to all life, all existence, from the beginning of time. Both contain records of past, present, and future events. However, the different cultures have a different context and terminology that's used when you start to break down the inscription of both concepts. So Akashic Records, on the other hand, they transcend specific religious boundaries. So when you talk about the Book of Life, you kind of contain to talking about religiosity and certain beliefs and denominations. When you talk about Akashic Records, it's transcending all religious boundaries. So it's seen as universal. It's a universal source of soul knowledge. And when you pray and you begin to ask God to give you revelation about into certain circumstances and situations, He'll sometimes reveal to you from records that have to do with a certain soulish realm, a mindset either of your family or of prior individuals. And so when you pray, God is answering your prayer and supplying your need according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus, which is vast. It's not going to just be limited to the boundaries that we set up. It's huge because it's all Him. He created it all. He set it all up. It won't exist unless it be underneath His authority. And so He will reach into whatever element He needs to reach into to answer and supply your need and answer your prayers and give you revelation. I'm going to stop right here. I'm not going to go any further. It's a whole lot more that we can talk about, but I promise that I would upload some videos that had to do with Akashic Records and give you an understanding, because I mentioned once before how in blood magic they use incantations and spells and certain things that, and information that they get from Akashic Records. And I know a lot of people were saying, well, what are Akashic Records? So I wanted to explain to you what they were. But everything that I give you, I'm going to give it to you from a biblical standpoint. I'm always going to give it to you from the standpoint, not of the counterfeit, but of the real, of the truth, so that you're not having to compare it with any fake. So when I give it to you, I give it to you from a standpoint of the truth. And I give you both concepts and both understanding so that you can go in and you can research and understand more of what you're receiving revelation about. Because, you know, God can give you revelation sometime, but if you're not aware of what he's talking about, I've had God to give me revelation on certain things and I had to go look them up. Like, what is this? And I'd have to study the word and then cross-reference with research to understand what he had just said to me and how I needed to apply it. What I'm here to share with you, what God tells me to share, as it involves the overcoming blood magic, series, recordings that we have on the YouTube channel. I think I've gone over everything that I wanted to share. There was something in the back of my mind. Oh, I wanted to say to you that a lot of people have been giving comments and I can't see them. That's because we've made this content available to children. So if you're trying to reach me and I'm not responding to you, you can always go to Facebook. And on Facebook, you can find me under Battle Jacqueline. Battle Jacqueline. On Facebook, you can find me under Battle Jacqueline. And you can send me a direct message. You can find me on Instagram under Jacqueline Battle, and you can send me a message there and I'll get your comments. But sometimes when you try to comment on the YouTube channel, it's not coming up because we've made it available for children, and that sort of limits a lot of the comments. Even though there is nothing in the comment that would be obscene, there are certain words that trigger. So they won't allow those comments to come over. I'm not ignoring any comments. I just can't see them. I want to tell you again, thank you so much for joining me this evening as we talk about Akashic Records and how they bear witness and how they are used in blood magic, but they can also be used for the kingdom of God in conjunction with the book of life. And we'll talk more about this and how you can apply this and the purpose and the intention of what we're talking about and why we release these videos. I'm so grateful to you. I know I'm always taking my glasses off and putting them back on. Somebody's reminding me of that. Y'all just have to forgive me for that. They're off and on. And I know it's distracting, and I ask you to forgive me for that. But I want to say to you that I'm Jacqueline Battle, and I want to remind you that God loves you, and I'm praying for you. Blessings.